Alright, so my man TP showed up over here today. Better known as Big Money Grip. What other alias? What else you got? Well, you got something new for me now? What?
The greatest man alive.
What was that?
Big Money Genovese, the greatest man alive.
Yeah, so he stopped through today. He seen the thing about the Regal. He know I've been, how long I've been looking for one of these, Tommy?
Man, we was teenagers.
Yeah, mine got tore up.
I remember being on the 18th Street Mall. Now that goes way back.
Yeah.
Yes. It was wonderful times back then.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
That's when you can find some good brown weed.
I don't know. Did you ever see the? I posted a video of the cars I used to have, and I put it on the YouTube channel. And then it's just pictures of the cars. And then I had the picture of me, UJP, in the field next door to the house over there.
So I'm still. To this day, I'm a Lincoln lover.
He's still driving. I'm gonna show his old ugly Lincoln here in a minute.
Can't just be stinking.
Now hold on. See, they was always Ford. His dad, everybody. And I used to pull in. Man, what's your daddy? Your dad. I used to pull in. Your daddy have a fit. I pull in.
I don't want no what you call no GMs in my driveway.
No Buicks. I don't want no Buicks. Get that, he be cussing, get that dang Buick out of here.
He wasn't much of a Cadillac man either.
Yeah.
I don't know how many Cadillacs is in there.
Yeah, he was.
Jesse was more Cadillac.
Yeah, but yeah, the dad, he loved me, boy, but he used to love picking with me about those Buicks when I come in there. I don't care what was going on. Get that thing out of my drive.
Them was the days, man.
Yeah, those was the days, man.
I remember back in the days, we used to go ahead and you used to come on by, and I myself and Jesse was more up on cars than you was, or working on cars. Now, man, I'm well behind you now. Doing paint jobs and the
post. Yeah, my younger years, man, I was trying to be dressed and chasing and all things I shouldn't be chasing. And then next thing I know, I said, hey, I got off into the cars and never stopped. I remember way back, man, I think Jesse was like, he wanted a car with a sunroof. And I'm like, a sunroof? What is that? I didn't know what a sunroof was. And yeah, y'all knew about the cars and everything. I remember Jesse went that red my first 73 Electra. That 73 photo. I went took Jesse because he had his license. Well, Jesse was about 6 months to a year older than me. And he had his license before me. I took him. He brought my first car home. And I parked it in my cousin's house next door, and my dad didn't know about it. And when he found out, I'm gonna sue the man that sold you that car. He can't be selling you no car. He was pissed off, boy. You ain't driving that car that you got no insurance. I said, well, Dad, I just went and got insurance. Got my license, got insurance, man. Yeah,
we remember that. That blue 72 deuce and a quarter?
Yeah, that was the second car that I had, that 72. Yeah.
Now
then my third one was one of these. That 77 gray.
That silver?
Yeah, that silver
77.
Yeah, I painted the Playboy bunnies, had the Playboy bunnies painted on the mud flaps.
Okay.
Had the window, had the back window closed in like the limousine.
Okay.
Yeah.
The one I did was that Dookie Brown Richard Pryor.
Yeah, Mr. Pryor, yeah, that was.
I did that.
Yeah, that was my baby there, that 72. I used to call it Mr. Pryor because that end was crazy, boy, is what I used to say, so.
And then you had that 67 deuce and a quarter drop top?
Yeah, 68. 68. Okay. Yeah.
I dig that right there.
Yeah.
And I said, you made some beautiful cars.
But your dad taught you different, man. Y'all need, but you, come on now, eventually, you bought that 70 Deuce in the corner four, though.
Yellow,
and you used to run that baby too. What did that have in it? 455 or 430?
And a 455.
455. And I remember that car used to be parked over there on the north side. I used to look at it all the time. I didn't even know it was for sale.
Yeah, all of a sudden I seen it in the paper. And I said, man, let me go on over here, man, take a look at this car. Yeah, let me buy it.
Yeah, you bought. You surprised when you pulled up in that one, boy. I was like, Tommy. Mm-hmm. You know, so even today, he's still rolling his Lincolns. I'm going to show that here in a minute. I know Jesse was looking at something about that year, too, at one time. And then he said it was in Milwaukee. During the time he was staying in Milwaukee up there. And then he sold it, he told me right away, but he was looking for a convertible after that.
He had a green.
Maybe it was
71,
green.
Marquee.
Was it two-door?
Yeah.
Maybe it was green then.
I'm saying he had bought it out of Illinois.
Right. That's the one. That's the one.
The Oreo?
That's the one then. That's the one.
You know, and I wanted him to go ahead and fix it up. He had a bad timing chain. I told him, I said, man, I'll tear the front end down on it, put a chain on it. He just decided he was going to get rid of it.
Yeah, he told me he was selling it. Yeah.
I wish I would have got that car off of him.
Yeah. So, man, hey, I appreciate you stopping by today. But, yeah, I've been looking for this one for a long time, man. Mm-hmm. Finally found her. I don't know.
She gonna be looking all right. What do you think about that sunroof? You think about going ahead and putting glass in it?
No. I used to like I love these cars. Just, man, I'm telling you, the one I had, the black one, with the red interior, man, I love that car, man. Yeah.
But I knew they also came with T-top.
Yeah. I had a couple of T-top. I had a T-top car too, though. But you know, that moonroof was like hard to find.
Yeah.
I got that 75 with the T-tops in it still now.
Jesse, all you say, you ain't gonna buy no car if you don't have no sunroof in it. Nope.
Yeah, that's.
I can't buy no convertible.
I say the first time I ever heard of a sunroof was from y'all. I'm like, what? So then that's when I started. I think when I went and found that 83 Park Avenue, that's when I said, okay, I got to make sure I got a sunroof. That's why that car had the sunroof in it, because listening to y'all all the time, I said, man, I got to have a sunroof. Blow the brains out. Yeah, I always try to make sure I find something with a sunroof. That's why it took me so long to find one of these. Either trying to find a T-top, but I was just getting to the point. My guy Buick Bob had a car from California, but his son wanted that car. And it didn't have the moonroof or the sunroof or the T-tops. But I was getting like, I'm running out of time. I ain't gonna never find one. The prices keep going up. I said, so I ain't gonna ever be able to find one, you know? So I was just looking to get me a Regal, whether it had the T-top or the higher, you know, or the sunroof. And then on my birthday, man, I woke up, we was in Ohio visiting my daughter.
And
I was just, and something told me, say, you're always looking on Facebook Marketplace, and everybody be on the car. Everybody, you know, as soon as it's there, it's gone. Some told me, said, go back to the old school Craigslist. Went to Craigslist, he had just posted this car, and it was my birthday. So this is a birthday present to me. And then my dad was born, I was born on the 22nd, my dad was born on the 23rd. So I found it on my birthday and went and picked it up the next day. Yeah, on my dad's birthday. So, man, special. This one ain't going nowhere. That's for sure. I've been looking for this car way too long, man. Too long. But, yeah.
I know what you mean.
I appreciate you coming by. When you walk out, I'm going to go out and show this Lincoln that you in. You always had some clean ones, boy. I remember you had that Imperial.
I love that.
That Imperial. Two-door Imperial.
I can't
what year was that?
No more.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. They had
them going through the roof.
What year was that?
81
two-door, man. That baby was clean.
Maybe a little bit lighter color than that car.
Yeah, it was that green. And I remember, man, you let me drive it that day. We went up to Milwaukee.
Uh-huh.
Went all up by the lakefront. We was cruising all, you know, because you know me, I was always in the hood cruising around. No, man, it was people all off the balconies. That car we ride through, they getting up screaming and yelling. I'm like, man, Tommy, what you got here, man? This is a magnet right here, boy. This is a magnet.
When we pulled up at the bus stop, this is a new bus. You ain't nobody said, do you want to ride in my Mercedes? This ain't no Mercedes, close.
Yeah, there you go.
I love that car, man.
Then that same day we was up there, and we had the... We met those girls, and they told us to come by their place. And we pull over there. The boyfriend got mad. They got the fighting. They got
you
the fight.
Whispered in that brother's ear, and the dude just started knocking chicks out. I'm like, man, what did you tell this man?
Man, but remember what happened? instead of calling the police, somebody called the fire department.
I was cool. Back in the 60s,
huh? Yeah, as long as he was beating on them, he wasn't messing with us. So we had to leave him. We had to go on about our business that day, though. But boy,
yeah, I remember.
We had some times
in Milwaukee.
We had some times.
Them mind blower. Them speakers you had.
Yeah, those mind blower. I remember me and Jesse. When I first put those mind blowers in that, I think that was that 73.
73?
That 73 Burgundy. And,
yeah, we was pretty much same color car.
Yeah, we was way up, like on 11th Street up there. And it's a big valley. You go down the hill on 11th Street up there. And Jesse, we topped that hill. You know, we was always cruising, going slow. He said, man, look at them. They down there, they was like three blocks away dancing. He said, they dancing to your music. I said, no, they not. He said, cut it down. I cut it down. They walked back out the street because they had walked in the middle of the street and started dancing. I cut the music down. They walked out the street. And then when I cut it back up, they walked out the street dancing again. Yeah, those mind blowers, boy. You were bringing up the old clubs back in the days. Because, you know, I didn't hang out in Racine too much. I was always in Milwaukee. You mentioned who?
I'm in Papagayo's, Intern East, Sonny's on Broadway. Man, I go over there with the Murphy boys, especially Brad. When Brad had that 72 Sabre.
Right.
Man, that sucker was crazy, too.
Yeah, yeah.
Now, that's another Buick man right there.
Right. Yeah, I used to be up there by myself a lot. I couldn't be down here. I used to be up there all the time. All right, so what year is this one, TP?
2010.
2010? Okay. How many miles you got going? This boy always liked his Lincolns, I'm telling you.
This broad almost got 200,000 miles on it.
It's running 200,000?
Yeah, 190.
She look pretty nice, my man. Boy, if we could just go back 30 years, huh?
Yep.
Oh, so when you start that up, it automatically come out?
Yeah, it's right here. It'll go back in as soon as you cut it off.
Oh, man.
Yeah, this thing got things happening to it that I don't even know about.
There you go. All right. Yeah, she's pretty nice, girl. Yes, sir. You're always going fast.